Let's continue this problem of matching the string mean against the string name. From where I left off in a previous clip. So I want to compute the cost right here. And again, there are three ways to get there. One is to advance on the mean string, but keep the name string where I currently am. So that would mean inserting a gap into the name string. So to insert a gap adds a cost of 2. 3 plus 2 gives me 5. Or I can go from here, which is to advance both on the mean and the name string. And so that's matching n to a to n. That's a cost of 3. 3 plus 4 is 7. Or in this way, insert a gap. 6 plus 2 is 8. And so my minimum cost of those three is the 5. So that's the minimum cost. And I got there from right here. 3 plus 2 gives me a 5. Okay, for this point right here, I can add 2 to get a for the gap, get a cost of 4, or I can go from here, 3 plus the cost to match A to A, so that's 3 plus 0 gives me 3, or I can add a gap, 5 plus 2 gives me 7, so the minimum will be 3. Here, got there from this point. Okay, right here I can add a gap from here, so that would give me 6. I can take 2 plus the cost of A to M. That's 2 plus 3 gives me 5. Or I can take 3 plus 2 to give me 5. So my minimum will be the 5, and I actually can get there two ways. 2 plus 3 and 3 plus 2. Okay. Here I can add the gap, so 4 plus 2 gives me 6. I can advance them both, so that's 4 plus the cost to match A to E. 4 plus 1 gives me 5, or I can add a gap, that's 7, so the minimum would be the 4 plus 1 to give me 5. 4 plus 1 to give me 5, okay. Almost done with this problem, and then we can talk about it. Here, to get to here, I can add a gap to the name string, so 5 plus 2 gives me 7. Here I can advance on both strings, so 6 plus 0 gives me 6. N matches against N with a cost of 0, so that gives me 6. Or I can add 2 for my insert a gap on the mean string, so the minimum cost will be right here. 6 plus 0 gives me a 6. Right here, I will have to go up. 3 plus 2 gives me a 5. 5 plus the cost to match N and A. 5 plus 3 gives me 8. 6 plus 2 gives me 8. So my best bet will be this. 3 plus 2 gives me 5. Okay, from here, I've got 5 plus 2 gives me 7. I've got 3 plus the cost of N to M, that's 3 plus 1 gives me 4, 5 plus 2 gives me 7, so 4 is my best, my minimum. All right, and here I've got 5 plus 2 to give me 7, 5 plus the cost of matching N and E has a cost of 3, so 5 plus 3 gives me 8, or 4 plus 2 to give me 6, so that's the one that I like. Right there. Okay, so now at this point, what I have to match the entire string M-E-A-N against the entire string N-A-M-E, I will have an optimal cost of 6. And now what I want to do is do the trace back. Since I was drawing the arrows here, we can just follow our arrows backward and see what our string matching is going to be. So to get our optimal cost right here, what I had to do was this step right here. That's my arrow. And what that step means is that I'm going to regress one on the name string, and I'm going to match it to a blank on the mean string. So I'll regress one on the name string, and there'll be a blank on the mean string. Okay? And then from here, I go to here, and that means I backtrack on both strings. both the mean and the name. So we'll have this right here. And then from here, got to it from this point right here, so I backtrack on both strings so the A matches against the A like so. To get to this point right here, I followed this arrow. What that arrow means is that I had to insert a blank on the name string and regress one on the mean string. So I need to insert a blank on the name string. Whoops, I got that. I've got to go over here. I need to insert a blank on the name string and regress one on the mean string, so that matches to there. And then from here, to go back, I need to go back on both right there. So I can see by calculating my cost, I've got 1 plus 2 plus 0 plus 1 plus 2, 3, 4, 6. So there's my cost right there. Okay, so you can see how I went backwards to do my trace back to figure out what the proper matching is.